Our big story tonight at 6, the myths, misconceptions, and misunderstandings regarding the governor's gun control bill are said to be consuming the Senate.
Yeah, discussion began today in earnest, and it's expected to last the rest of the week.
Because I've heard some people tell me we need this bill because right now there are people falling through the cracks that I don't have to go through background checks. And I'm just thinking right now it doesn't sound
No. Yeah. Everybody, and you hear a lot about the gun show loophole. Yeah. No gun show loophole in Maryland.
So the question is the license per person or per gun?
It's per person.
So if I get a license January 1st, 2014, I can then use that license to buy a gun once a month.
Exactly.
Opponents contend the bill violates Second Rights Amendments. Second Amendment rights, I should say. The required new gun purchasers to apply for a license and then provide a fingerprint. It bans assault-style weapons and prohibits people who have been involuntarily committed for mental health reasons from owning a gun. Lobbying is intense and, we're told, sometimes done secretly. 11 News reporter David Collins joins us live from Annapolis tonight. He has details for us. David?
Well, Rod, amidst the noisy gun control debate, we discovered a subtle private lobbying campaign where gun control legislators are shooting firearms targeted to be banned in Maryland. You're watching a covert gun rights lobbying operation. This is an invitation-only affair for Maryland legislators. It's being held on private property on Maryland's Eastern Shore. Guests don't want the public to know or see them shooting firearms, because, according to one of those attending, it doesn't look good politically. Cecil County Republican Delegate Michael Schmiegel, the guy on the phone next to this black SUV limo, organized it.
The legislators getting out there have never had any experience, have an opportunity to actually know what they're voting on.
The limo pulled up next to the House building. Democrats who support gun control piled in. Delegate Schmiegel is trying to change their hearts and minds by giving them firearm instruction, a taste of how much fun and sportsmanlike it is to fire a legal weapon. The same type of guns lawmakers may soon vote to ban in Maryland.
So when we talk about a feature of a firearm, they can actually look and see what it actually does.
He takes them to a private NRA-sanctioned target range just over the Chesapeake Bay Bridge, on the grounds of a $2.7 million estate. This excursion includes Baltimore City delegates Nathaniel Oakes, Talmadge Branch, and Kurt Anderson. Watch how the gun barrel moves slightly as Delegate Branch pulls the trigger.
It didn't change my mind because it only made it that much more clear that we have to do something.
We emailed a photo of the gun table to Vincent Salisbury, the owner of Duffy's Gun Shop in Baltimore County. He says all the weapons are a variation of an AR-15 assault-styled rifle, the type of weapon used in the Aurora, Colorado movie theater shooting, and similar to the Bushmaster used in the Newtown, Connecticut school massacre. Delegate Schmiegel's private gun school points out the difference between an assault and an assault-styled weapon, how pistol grips make a gun easier to handle, and that an adjustable stock simply changes the size of a weapon.
Oh, it was definitely an experience I'd never had before, but I asked him, I said, well, how come I can only shoot one at a time? And he said, well, no, this is a sporting rifle. An assault rifle is where you can squeeze the trigger and have multiple bullets come out.
I know we changed some minds. I heard people looking at these and saying, we're regulating that? Why?
Delegate Schmiegel has been holding these private gun sessions for the past 3 years. As far as the debate, the Senate is expected to take up amendments to the governor's gun bill tomorrow and possibly vote on it by Friday. Reporting live from Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.